Punishment. What is punishment? The definition of punishment is the affliction of a penalty as retribution for an offense. Punishment is a little bit different than discipline. Discipline is the practice of training people to obey rules of behavior. What most of us do is we use punishment to correct discipline during training. As we begin this series on punishment, I first want to introduce you to the story of the prodigal son. It's found in the Bible, and whether you're a Christian or not, this doesn't matter as far as understanding the topic at hand. And we're talking about punishment here. And it's an interesting parable to think about as regards to punishment. The story comes from the book of Luke, and I'm going to go ahead and just read the story first, and then we're going to discuss it.
There was a man who had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, "Father, give me the share of property that is coming to me." And he divided his property between them. Not many days later, the younger son gathered all he had and took a journey into a far country, and there he squandered his property in reckless living. And when he had spent everything, a severe famine arose in that country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into his fields to feed the pigs. And he was longing to be fed with the pods that the pigs ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired servants have more than enough bread, but I perish here with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants.' And he arose and came to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and felt compassion and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his servants, 'Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put on a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring the fattened calf and kill it, and let us eat and celebrate. For this is my son who was dead and is alive again. He was lost and now is found.' And they began to celebrate. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. He called one of his servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, 'Your brother has come, your father has killed the fattened calf, because he has received him back safe and sound.' But he was angry and refused to go in. His father came out and entreated him, but he answered his father, 'Look, these many years I have served you. I never disobeyed your command, yet you never gave me a young goat that I might celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours came, who has devoured your property with prostitutes, you killed the fattened calf for him.' And he said to him, 'Son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. It was fitting to celebrate and be glad, for this your brother was dead and is alive. He was lost and now is found.'"
If you were the dad in the parable, what would you have done? Imagine if your son or daughter someday goes off the deep end. How are you going to react? The story of the prodigal son, it illustrates a principle we all need in punishment. The number one thing that we need to remember as dads in regard to punishment is grace. And I want to introduce to you now Professor Scott Keith, and he's going to talk more about this thing called grace.
The reason I use the prodigal son story is it's the most powerful picture I think that we have in the scriptures, where Christ uses a parable, about a father and his two sons the theology that's going on here is he's doing two things. He's showing us the picture of a gracious father, and he's relating that to God our Father, right? So he tells us the story of a good and gracious father who acts in a way that we wouldn't expect, a way that's contrary to us. And he shows us that as the picture of a good and gracious father, and then he says, "Your Father in heaven is like this too." There's a a scholastic theologian, a Roman Catholic theologian, Thomas Aquinas, that first came up with the idea that we have some ways that we speak about God that are analogies. He called it an analogia entis, or an analogy of being, that we have there. We can speak of things in this world that are not completely unlike God and that are not completely like God, but they are analogies to God. And one of those things, I believe, are good and gracious fathers. That when we speak of a good and gracious father, or when we show a picture of a good and gracious father, we can say, look, when I say that God is good and kind and gracious and forgiving towards you, I'm not saying he's exactly like that good and gracious and kind forgiving father over there, nor am I saying he's exactly unlike that good and gracious father over there. I'm saying that that good and gracious father is an analogy to what I'm talking about when I say God is good and gracious and kind and forgiving on account of Christ towards you. And the story of the prodigal son is probably the most didactic portion of Scripture where we have that laid out for us by Christ himself. But that when we hear that story as men, I think we want to see ourselves as the father. We want to see ourselves as this good and gracious dad, or we think he's crazy, maybe one of the two. But the reality is that I think most often we are either the licentious and entitled younger son, or we're the obstinate and slightly petulant older son, and we actually act either like the one who is lawless or the one who is too lawful, and not the father who is actually good and gracious.
Do you act more like the lawless brother, the lawful brother, or the dad? As dad, since we all deal with rule breaking, we'll all at some point have to be the gracious father.